So I wanted to do a literature review, and I wanted a way to showcase it. We came up with the idea of doing a map. Mostly, I love maps, so I wanted to do a map. And then two, maps are really easy to use for not just researchers, but community members who are living in an area can kind of zoom in and click on a research nearby, and hopefully we'll have kind of a summary of what it's about so that it's not just people in the field, but people outside of the field and community members can understand as well. So what this is supporting is a larger network of people all interested in saltwater intrusion and sea level rise. And hopefully this will be kind of the basis of where you go first when you have a question of, let's click on a point. I want to know what is happening in the Alligator River National Wildlife Refuge because I'm interested in studying there. You can click on that point and say, oh, this person, and this person have these cool projects there. Let me reach out to them to see if they need any help or if I can add anything else in there.
So on a day-to-day, I come in and try to check in with the students from time to time to make sure that they feel like they're on track and that we're homing in on a clear end product. So what that looks like is I'm helping them get this data in a format that makes sense, and I'm helping them learn how to work with this high-resolution complex spatial data.
My biggest role really, especially in our meetings that we had every week, was looking at sort of the analytic framework, how the data sets were coming together, sort of bigger picture things, what kind of tests or models do we want to run, what are we sort of moving towards in terms of this analysis plan, how do we interpret the results, how do we convey those results, those sort of bigger picture things that are sort of the result of all the coding and skills that they had. That was sort of the main way that I think I contributed.
Well, being able to explain your research and your work to others is a fundamental part of research, not just as a grad student, but as a postdoc and as a professor. And, being able to, and also collaboration between people in different fields is, that is a very fundamental part of data science, but it's also an important part in many other fields as well. In fact, you often find sometimes the most exciting research happens at the intersection of different fields. And by definition, if you have research that you're doing at the intersection of different fields, you're going to be interacting with people with a different background from yours who don't necessarily speak the same language that you do. And so being able to explain the concepts that you're interested in, that you're exploring, not in the language of your academic bubble, but just practically and for people that don't speak that language is actually very important.
Yeah, I mean, I think it probably expands more than refines. I think it's probably a thing that, the results that we've come out with, I think have, if anything, made me sort of expand to include more outcomes and think more about mental health and healthcare utilization.
I have gotten a lot out of it, and I know that for a fact, and now I'm trying to think of the concrete things that have happened throughout the summer. One is just being in charge of a group of people. In my PhD, I had kind of undergraduate students helping me out throughout my projects, but it was more of one-offs and kind of single tasks, and so being the manager of a project, I think, selfishly is really beneficial for me since I want to be in that role of managing a project and seeing it being pushed forward and not just me working on one of my chapters in my dissertations, but to see the bigger picture of a full project.
But it was really more sort of big picture, interesting sort of research and data discussions and questions and things like that, putting together results, figures, and tables for the poster, presentations, things like that. And that was really rewarding. I mean, it's not that different from the kind of stuff that I do normally as a grad student. So it was definitely really fun.
How hard is it to make something generalizable? I think that's something with modeling that people talk about a lot, is looking into a very specific place and then trying to scale up to a big picture.
And it was really interactive, and it felt more, it was like a meeting, and I think having a teaching style that sort of is similar to that, where it's really engaging and you're not just standing up there talking and having nobody listen to you. That's definitely something that was fun and I think would be good to bring to the classroom.
It is true that you learn more when you a good way for you to learn is to explain things to others and teach it to others. And so, you know, going over some more basic stats and computer science concepts that I learned in my undergrad with them has made me really go back and remember like how I learned it and how I found it useful. Like the explanations that my professors would give me, the ones that I found useful in giving that to them. And that has actually really deepened my knowledge of those concepts, even though they were things that I've done 3, 4, or 5 years ago.
And I know that a lot in like computer science, it's talked about where you have the skills and you can apply it to any discipline. And so I think that that was proven right, that I gave them this concept.